Hey guys, it's David from mtbootstrap.com. In this video, I'm gonna show you my list of the most common JavaScript snippets. So every developer, when he creates different projects, realizes at a certain point that some pieces of code has been already used in the previous project. So what do? Usually you try to get to the previous source code and find out this piece of code. So this is very wise to create your list, your snippets, your useful JavaScript snippets, and keep it somewhere aside so you don't have to look for the same piece of code over and over again. So today I'm gonna share with you my list of snippets, so the functions which I use quite often in the different projects. You're gonna find links to the repository in the description down below, and without further ado, let's get started and see what I prepared for you. So as I mentioned, you can download this list of the snippets. It's gonna grow in the future, so if you don't want to miss that, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and turn notification on. So let's go through the list of my snippets. Let's go from the top. So the very first, detect device. Here you can see the function called is Apple device. So this one is meant to recognize whether this whether the device used to browse our website is an Apple device. Obviously I'm here on the Windows, so I should get false, but the trick here is that we are checking the navigator platform. Now keep in mind that this can be easily tricked, so this is not the security measure, it's more of general information. So if you want for some reason to display something differently on different devices, you can check for navigator platform, and here below you're gonna find a list of different navigator platforms. So if you want to see how Linux, for example, introduced itself in a browser, you're gonna check against that list. So let's have a look, how does it work. Let me open a console. And yeah, let's use this function here. And obviously now if I'm gonna call it, I should get false. And this is the result. Okay, now let's move on to the last item. So this is another very, very useful function which I use. So very often you want to get to the last item either of your array, set, or a map. So having this function which take care of all of them, you don't need to think whether it's array, it's set, or it's map. It's, you're always gonna get the last item. And let's have a look at this example. It's commented here. So the very first one is with the array. So array, and now last item from our cars will give us BMW, right? As expected. Now let's go to set. As you can see, set accept different types of variables. So you can have numbers, you can have text, you can have objects. And currently our object is the last element. So let's check last item of our my set. And we got the object and finally map. So let's create some map and get last item map, which is bool. Okay, so now let's move to random number. So this tiny function is very, very useful. So this allows us to create a random number from a given range. So for example, from let's say 10 to 0, we want to get some random numbers. And obviously if you want to have different range, you can easily change it. It's very tiny, but you would be surprised how often you have to randomize your numbers. Now, the other interesting trick which I use is when you want to create required parameter. So you want to have a function with a required parameter. So you know that your functions won't gonna work without this parameter. So how to enforce user to provide you the parameters? So this is the way. And now let's have a look how it works. So if I'm gonna call this function, I have required options without the parameters, I'm gonna get error. As you can see, argument one is required, and this is expected result. So This will make sure that whoever uses this function will have to think of parameters. So let's see what's going to happen if I'm going to provide the parameter. Now it will work. As you can see, it accepts two arguments. So the second one is optional here, and we also provide a default value. As you can see also here, this is a clear difference between a default value for an argument and between the required argument. And obviously, if you want to provide both parameters, we can still do that. And let's see what's going to happen. If we're going to provide undefined, then we're also going to get an error. Okay, another interesting function and very often used is conversion from RGB to hex and from hex to RGB. So these two functions allows us to do it quickly. So let's have a look at RGB to hex first. So this will convert our red, green, blue to hex value, and also the other way around. This function hex to RGB returns either the object with all the three values, or we can get only a certain value like green. And this also extended version, which also take care of shortened version. So sometimes you're gonna see hex value like this one, 03F, and this will also work like a charm. The next very interesting and very useful piece of JavaScript code is a swap function. So if you want to swap your elements with an array, you can easily do it calling this swap function. So if I'm gonna do swap, provide the array as an argument, and now I decide which arguments I want to swap. Let's say first and last one. So this is gonna swap this element with 96 with 12, and you can see it here. Obviously, we can change this configuration to 1 and 2. So we're gonna swap the middle numbers, or we can do it like that, and this will work like a charm. And finally, I think one of the most common actually piece of code, so unique ID generator. So let me paste it here. I'm gonna go through all of them because we have few different options here. So the very first one is unique ID, which is based on the timestamp. So it will increment ID every time we request it. So the very first is built based on the timestamp, and then it will increase by one. Then we have unique incrementing ID. So if you want to start from zero and you want to, you know, have orders like this with leading zeros, you can use this function for that. If you want to more randomized ID, you can have unique alphanumeric ID, which gonna use also the numbers and characters. And finally, UUID. So the UUID stands for Universal Unique Identifier. So I think this is the most common ID used in the corporate world. Its uniqueness does not depend on the central registration authority or coordination between the parties generating them. So unlike the other, you know, number schemes, the point is that you can use this function in different places, and the probability that you're going to have the same ID, and obviously you don't want that because you want to have your ID to be unique. Well, it's not zero, but it's close enough to zero to be negligible. So the probability to find a duplicate within 103 trillion versions of UUID is 1 in a billion if we're gonna use version 4, because there are different versions of this UUID. We're gonna use the version 4, which is the random one. So let's have a look how does it look like. So this UUID version 4, and this is how this ID looks like. So as you can see, it's quite long, and also it contains dashes. And it contains dashes, which, by the way, you can skip to make it shorter. But you have to, if you want to keep the format, then you have to add them later on. But yeah, that makes sure that you're almost never gonna get collision. So yeah, These are my initial snippets. I'm gonna create the second part of this video in the future, but for now, thank you very much for watching. I strongly suggest you to go through all of them and check one by one, because you know you can also learn by reading someone else's code. If you don't understand something, please do not hesitate to ask. Do not hesitate to leave the comment down below. Also, please do join our Facebook group, where you're gonna find the answer to all your questions. And please let me know in the comments what are your most common JavaScript functions, JavaScript snippets, which you use in your project often. So thank you very much again for watching, and see you in the next. We'll be right back.